us ambassadors of reconciliation in this world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, our Father, who called St. Francis Xavier Cabrini from Italy to serve the immigrants of America, by her example, teach us to have concern for the stranger, sick, and all those in need. And by her prayers, help us to see Christ in all men and women we meet. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. John. Chosen lady, I rejoice greatly to find some of your children walking in the truth, just as we were commanded by the Father. But now, lady, I ask you, not as though I were writing a new commandment, but the one we've had from the beginning, let us love one another. For this is love, that we walk according to his commandments. This is the commandment, as you heard from the beginning, in which we should walk. Many deceivers have gone out into the world, those who do not acknowledge Jesus Christ as coming in the flesh. Such is the deceitful one, the Antichrist. Look to yourselves that you do not lose what you work for, but may you receive a full recompense. Anyone who is so progressive as not to remain in the teaching of the Christ does not have God. Whoever remains in the teaching as the Father and the Son. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond. Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Blessed are they whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Blessed are they who observe his decrees, who seek him with all their heart.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
With all my heart I seek you. Let me not stray from your commands.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Within my heart I treasure your promise, that I may not sin against you.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Be good to your servant, that I may live and keep your words.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Open my eyes, that I may consider the wonders of your law.
Blessed are they who follow the law of the Lord.
Similarly, as it was in the days of Lot, they were eating, drinking, buying, selling, planting, building. On the day when Lot left Sodom, fire and brimstone rained from the sky to destroy them all. So what will be on that day the Son of Man is revealed? On that day, someone who is on the housetop and whose belongings are in the house must not go down to get them, and likewise one in the field must not return to what was left behind. Remember the wife of Lot. Whoever seeks to preserve his life will lose it, but whoever loses it will he said to them, where the body is, there also the vultures will gather. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We're told in that first reading from John's letter that we are to remain in the teaching of Christ, and whoever remains in the teaching has the Father and the Son. We remember St. Francis Xavier Cabrini, an Italian who was asked by Pope Leo XIII to come to the United States to work with the hundreds and thousands of Italian immigrants who were coming over in the 19th century. And she had a great gift for organizing people and setting up institutions. She did that in North America and South America. She founded a religious community. She served in New York City for a long time and in Chicago. Anybody knows Cabrini Green, that housing project in Chicago was named after St. Francis Cabrini. She was a person, though, who recognized that she came to help the other Italian immigrants, that what was most needed is what John was writing about in his first letter, is that they should know the law of the Lord, and if they could live in that law, they would live with the Father and the Son. And so she became a great educator. And for that reason, it behooves each of us to ask ourselves, I say I believe, I believe I believe, but do I really understand all the words of God, the commands of God, the teachings of Christ? Most of the saints would have responded, well, I do believe, but I spend a whole lifetime trying to understand the teachings of Christ. In discussions with people, many times I'll be coming up with a topic, and as we address it, they'll say, well, this is what I believe. And I'm saying to them, but that's not what the church believes, it's not what the scripture says. Well, that's just what I believe. And you become aware of the fact that all of us need an ongoing conversion in which we're constantly being challenged by the Word of God in Christ Jesus our Lord that's been revealed to us by His Spirit. So today, as we gather around this altar for the Eucharist, let us keep in mind this first half of this celebration, the Liturgy of the Word. That is what we are called to constantly be open to, and whose commands we are called constantly to follow. Let us stand. Let us pray. To pray for the safety of all travelers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those working with immigrants throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For immigrants themselves, that they would always be open to the Word of God and to the grace of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people involved in Christian education, that they might realize the importance of their work, and that those who are catechists would constantly be open to learning themselves, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray too for the people fighting the pandemic on the front lines and for those who suffer from that affliction, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace throughout our world and for negotiated settlements to international disputes, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Zaneda, Madeline, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Through the prayers we make, O Lord, as we gather around your altar, strengthen us now and always through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
For the mystery of this water and wine, we become to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the body and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual man.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty. Consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. It is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness and bring it to experience here on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. So with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Give holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, will be up for you." In a similar way, when someone was ready to take the chalice, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice, one new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When
we eat this bread and drink this cup, we will proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, by giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in the presence of ministry. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Daniel our Bishop, Louis his assistant bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostle, peace I leave you, and peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the Church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Share and believe. Our second option, communion and fast.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
renewed by partaking of this divine gift, we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of Blessed Francis Xavier Cabrini, bearing in our body the death of Jesus, we may strive to hold fast to you alone. This we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us all.